Friends, couple of years back, I got a chance to, you know, choose a language between Go and Rust, and I have chosen Go, and I am working in Go language from last couple of years. I have learned it, I have created production code in it, and to some extent, I am fluent in Go as of today. And I am going to tell you something which I never thought I will say as a programmer. I am saying, let's go. Yes, you heard it right. I am saying let's go because, you know, I am liking Go language a lot. I may be having my own personal reasons for the same, but I want to share with all of you so that, you know, you understand why I am saying this. Now, before I go ahead and tell you everything about Go language, let me tell you that a couple of years back, I got a choice between learning Go or Rust. Now, both these languages are great. And I believe that if there is any language which can come closer to maybe replacing C and C++ in the future, it may be one of these two languages or even both of them. Of course, this is not going to happen in near future, and in long-term future, anything can happen. But as of today, this is my personal opinion on these two languages. Now, why I chose Go? So the idea is that, you know, I'm a backend kind of engineer and most of my work is in backend. I have very limited work in front end. Backend means I am gonna write code which is gonna run on a server which is a multi-core server. And Go is the only language which was created considering these multiple cores, multiple CPUs in mind. When Go was created, the primary intention was to create a language which can be used seamlessly in multi-core system, multi-CPU systems. That's the reason I have selected Go and I am working on it. Now, you know what, over a period of time, I realized that Go language is the breath of fresh air considering all other programming languages around. I'm going to talk about this, but let me clarify that I'm not saying that Go language or any other language is the unicorn for everything you want to do. No, nothing like that. There are importance for each and every language, and each and every language is excel in one or other scenario, situations, conditions. And something which I am saying all the time, that in computer science, if a language is not required, it will not exist. It exists only and only because it is required for doing something where it excels. Now let's come back to Go language. Today, if you consider any other object-oriented programming language like C++, Java, Python, JavaScript, and many other languages, you will see one thing. All the languages are trying to become same, you know. All the functionalities that are there in one language will be, you know, either is there right now or will be coming in future. Think about functional programming, think about Lambda, think about classes, inheritance, abstraction, and because of that, you will end up using all those patterns like, you know, solid patterns, dependency injection, and many other things which is, you know, prominent and can be used in all object-oriented programming languages. Now, as a programmer, I have some issues with it because every programming language is trying to do everything what other programming language is doing, and there is no novelty out there. Of course, you know, some thing runs faster in some cases, some things are having a framework which is very useful, but there is no novelty out there. Go in that case is a breath of fresh air, really fresh air, because it is not an object-oriented programming language. It is very similar to C, which means that as a programmer, I can, you know, bring in my own creativity to create programs without worrying about too much of the patterns like how to create things. Think about it. I'm not saying that all these patterns which are created for object-oriented programming like solid, all those injections and other things are not good, not useful. They are good, they are useful. But your software is all about the functionality it achieves. It's not about how you create your objects, how you pass dependency. Your functionality has limited things to do about that. Or I can say it has nothing to do about that. It's all about your functionality. And when I write any object-oriented code today, be it in C++ or Java, it is so much framework-oriented, so much, you know, patterns-oriented that if somebody is reviewing my code, even if they do not understand an iota of it, they will try to ask for whether I am following single responsibility principle, I am using this framework, I am doing injection or not. All those things you must ask, but as I said earlier, it has nothing to do with the functionality you are trying to implement. And in that sense, Go gives me freedom to do many things without, you know, imposing a set of standard which may or may not be valuable for the work you are trying to do, for the problem you are trying to solve. And this is one of the primary reasons I fall in love with Go language. And not only this, there are a few other things which are so much embedded into this, like Go routines, channels, inter-channel communications, and many other things which are just part of the language. And we feel so much at home while creating all those things for a multi-core system. It feels really easy, and you know, Go routines are lightweight user space threads, and when I actually run my system and compared with systems written in other programming languages, of course how you write code makes the difference, what framework you use makes the difference, but let me tell you one statement very clearly, I was impressed by it. So that's the reason there are some of the work which I'm going to continue in Go language. And yes, Go language videos are coming in this channel. I'm gonna create those videos in some time. So that's all I wanted to talk to you today. Thank you all. Thanks for watching. We will meet again. Until the next time we meet, good day, goodbye. You take care.